Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture.
In this video, I will show you a game between Alexander Onischuk and Varuzhan Akobian. This is a game from the United States Championship played in St. Louis in 2018. Onischuk had white pieces and he started with d4. Akobian played e6, c4. Black to move. Akobian didn't play d5. He played f5, the Dutch defense. Knight to c3, knight to f6, g3, d5, the Stonewall Dutch. Bishop to g2, c6, white to move. Knight to h3 was played. Knight to f3 is the most played move. Knight to h3, bishop to d6, and both players cast at kingside. White to move. Queen to c2 was played. Bishop to f4 is the most played move, and perhaps this is the most logical, especially if black takes on f4, then knight comes in the game. Knight takes on f4. Back to our game. We have a queen to c2. D takes on c4. e4 threatening. e5 forking two pieces. e5 preventing white from playing e5. And bringing the bishop on c8 in the game. Pawn takes pawn on f5. E takes on d4, attacking the knight. Knight to e2. c5. d3 doesn't work because of queen takes on c4 check, and after king to h8, queen takes on d3. So we have c5 defending the pawn. Queen takes on c4 check. King to h8. White to move. Knight to g5 was played. Very tempting, isn't it? Intending knight to f7 check. Another way to go was b4, undermining the pawn on d4. But who can resist a knight to g5? Knight to c6. Knight to f7 check is possible. Bishop to f4 was played. Bishop takes on f5. Knight to f7 check. And black had to take. If king goes to g8, how would you continue? Do you take the queen, or do you go for the smothered checkmate? This one, or that one? What is your choice? This is better than smothered checkmate. Why? Because there is no smothered checkmate. If queen to g8 check, then knight takes on g8. And knight to f7 doesn't work, because rook takes knight. Back to our game. Rook takes on f7 was played. Queen takes on f7. Rook to b8 defending the pawn on b7. Bishop takes on c6. B takes on c6. Rook from f to e1. d3. Attacking the knight, a pawn with a dream, with a big dream. Not just to take the knight, but to reach d1 square. Bishop takes on d6, the idea is to bring the rook to e7. Queen takes bishop on d6, knight to c3. d2, attacking the rook, rook to e7, threatening queen takes on g7, check, mate. Defending, rook takes on a7. Bishop to g4. Black to move, and black is already in a panic mode. Queen to e7 was played. Rook to e7 would be a better move. Pawn to d1, queen doesn't work. Because of knight takes on d1, and after bishop takes on d1, queen to e6. White is okay. Not winning, but okay. Back to our game. Queen to e7 was played. Queen takes queen. Rook takes on e7. And this is the move that is coming now, is the move that Onischuk missed. What is it? What is the best move for black in this position? The move that wins the game is knight to d5, attacking the rook and one of the defenders of d1 square. White to move. Rook to e2 was played. f3 would offer a better resistance. After bishop takes on f3, then rook to d7, and the game would last longer. Black is still better. Back to our game. Rook to e2 was played, and this move loses on the spot. Black played the move and white resigned. Please pause and find the best move for black. Did you pause or did you find? Akobian played. Pawn to d1, queen. Player with white pieces on his chook resigned. If knight takes on d1, then bishop takes on e2. a4 doesn't work, because after rook to a8, the knight is stuck on d1. If knight goes to e3 or c3, he gets chopped. What else can white do? In this position, if rook takes on d1, then knight takes on c3, and after b takes on c3, bishop takes rook, and again, black is easily winning. And let's go back to this interesting position. In this position, after check, queen takes on f7. Onischuk believed he was winning. The black passed pawn on d4 proved to be too dangerous. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.